Hi, I'm going to talk about parenting today. So, I wrote a blog about this that you can read on AnnetteTalks.com, and this vlog is going to be on there as well. But this is what's going on. I have a child that's extremely difficult. If you know me, you know this, but I've been trying to fix her for several years now. She's been having these really big tantrums where, whenever she doesn't get her way, she tries to control me, bully her sisters. I've been called names, I've been spit on, I've been bit. She's pulled out a knife a couple times. And for a while there, she was telling me she wanted to kill me. And it got to be so regular that she would tell me this that I started thinking about Princess Bride and the Dread Pirate Roberts, who would tell Wesley, "Good night, go to bed. I'll most likely kill you in the morning," or something like that. And so I started thinking about that every time she would say it. All these things are unpleasant, and then she's young enough that they didn't really scare me, but they were very disheartening. And obviously, we did not have a peaceful home when this was going on. And I spent a lot of time and energy trying to figure out what to do. I went to a parenting class that the school district offered on dealing with strong-willed children. I got the book on strong-willed children and read that. I got other books that special ed teachers recommended to me. Any other books I could get my hands on that I thought would help. I took her for a psychological evaluation. They diagnosed her with intermittent explosive disorder, which to me sounded made up, IED. Well, that's pretty accurate, really, because often it felt like we had an improvised explosive device in the home. And they gave me some recommendations, which I followed. A few of those were family counseling. We were already there. I had her in counseling. I was in counseling. I was talking to her counselor. They said enroll her in sports or things that help her self-esteem. Did that. There were a few other things they told me to do. Did everything. Followed all the recommendations. Things just weren't getting better. So finally, the counselor and I decided that medication would be the next step. Took her to a psychiatric nurse practitioner. She kind of half-heartedly recommended some medication. She wasn't totally sold on it, but she could see I needed something. We started her on that at a really low dose. It was non-therapeutic, so she wasn't really feeling the effects of it, but we were just kind of getting her used to it. And then one day I went onto Facebook and I posted to my friends and I said, "Hey, what do you guys do when your child says things to you that are cruel, to not take them personally?" And I got some really great responses. Well, one of them led me to an article, which then led me to a book. Peaceful Parent, Happy Kids by Dr. Laura Markham. And this book was a game changer. And I read this sucker and I started following what she said, and so much of it just resonated with me and rang true and worked. And so I'm going to summarize this for you, but I really recommend that you get this book on Amazon. It doesn't cost much. Read it, learn it, live it. The three C's, this is what I kind of break her book down into. She calls it the three big ideas, but it's for me, it's easy to remember the three C's. The first one is calm, or regulating yourself. And this is where you learn to regulate your own emotions so that when you're dealing with these kids, you stay calm. Okay, and this is huge. I'd always heard stay calm, but I just wasn't able to do it until I started reading the reasoning behind it. And she gives you a lot of tips on how to stay calm, how to regulate yourself, and why kids can get you so riled. Part of that is as kids that they are in a great position to push all your buttons. And one of the things she says is when you find a button, you need to figure out how to excavate that. Because these buttons are ours. They don't belong to our kids, they belong to us. So we need to learn how to regulate our emotions, and that might mean counseling. It might mean finding a buddy you can talk to about these things. It might mean, looking at your childhood and resolving issues. I did all these things. I was already kind of on this path of resolving issues, but this forced me to the next step. And so I am now calm, I would say 90% of the time when A is what I'll call her because all my girls are named A. Their first name begins with an A. And now I stay calm with her most of the time. That right there makes a huge difference. The second C is connection. And this means connecting with your child. The child needs to know that you love her unconditionally, no matter what, everything about her, you love her. And even if she has temper tantrums, all these big emotions, you're still there, you're always gonna be there, and you love her. She needs to really feel this. And the idea behind it is that if she knows that you love her, she's going to want to behave for you, because she wants to maintain that closeness. She wants to be like you. She wants to emulate you. She wants to please you. And so the ways that we can help her to feel connected, and I always use her because I have girls, but one of the ways is the book called Special Time, which is one-on-one time. You set aside 10 or 15 minutes a day where it's just you and this child. And if there's two parents, you each get to have the special time, which is even better. Special time where it's just one-on-one, you put your phone away, you turn it off, and you say, what do you want to do? And then the child gets to choose. Around our house, I spend a lot of time on the trampoline because two of my girls really love the trampoline, and the other one, we usually read a book. But whatever they want to do, it gives them time to bond with you, to feel appreciated, to feel listened to. And they know that they're valued and prized when you're taking this time out to spend with them. Another way is lots of hugs. The book talks about how there's a study that shows that 4 hugs a day is what you need for maintenance. 4 hugs a day is for survival. 8 hugs a day is for maintenance, and 12 hugs a day you thrive on. And so I always make a point now to make sure that they're all getting lots of hugs. A lot of times, when she's blowing up, I'll take her and put her on my lap and give her a big hug. And a lot of times that stops the tantrum right there. She feels connected again. She feels loved. And so that's huge. And there are a lot of other ways to connect in the book, but those are two of the big ones. And then the next three is coaching and not controlling. And so this kind of makes you really rethink the way you parent. We've all learned how to punish, how to discipline. This kind of turns that on its head, because punishment makes your child feel like your enemy. You kind of harden your heart towards them, and they feel like they are not in your good graces anymore. And that, it goes against what we're trying to do here, making them feel loved and connected. And so you need to learn to just give them guidelines that you set with empathy. And so while they have guidelines, you're not trying to control them. You're trying to coach them. And part of coaching is emotion coaching, because they don't know how to deal with these big emotions. And so you learn how to help them when they're starting to have these temper tantrums, how to release some of these emotions. Like two good ways is through giggling and through crying. And so we can, a lot of times we can get them to giggle, and it relieves a lot of stress, like maybe roughhousing with them, playful roughhousing, right? Playing with them. And sometimes if they're past the point of being able to giggle, holding them and giving them an empathetic boundary, like, no, I'm sorry you can't hit your sister, you can't be mean to the dog, and giving them an empathetic look until they know what they're doing is wrong and they cry. And so they let that emotion out with crying. And I recently heard from my counselor that 7 minutes of crying relieves stress by 40%. And so that's huge. So giggling and crying are two ways. Also, them seeing us remain calm helps them to learn how to process their emotions and to remain calm. So those are the three big C's. I'm only giving you a brief overview. I really, again, recommend get this book. Read it. It's on Amazon. It's like $10. Totally worth your money and your time. I can't emphasize how important good parenting is. I mean, I think of this, if we're doing these things, we're like that parent that we always wanted to have growing up, you know, that parent that we always can remember that loved us, that was totally connected with, totally involved in our lives, and gave us gentle guidance and correction. And I think if you watch the TV show This Is Us, the parent Jack is kind of like this. So if we want to be that kind of parent, then this is what we need to do. And parenting is the most important thing we're going to do in this life. It has eternal consequences, and also it affects the kind of home that we live in now. So that's it in a nutshell. Go get the book, learn it, live it, love it. Anyway, thanks for watching. Talk to you later.